everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about second order differential equations, and in this particular problem we're going to be working backwards. Normally in a second order differential equations problem, we're given the original equation that looks something like this and asked to find the general solution. And in this case, we're given the general solution and asked to find this original equation. So in this case, I've gone ahead and done the whole problem, then written out the steps in the normal direction so that we can kind of compare them. So again, normally we would start with this first step here and we would work this way. We would swap out our y double prime, y prime, and y for r squared, r, and 1, and then we would factor our problem. We would find the roots of the equation. In this case, you can see they are equal real roots because negative 10 and negative 10 are equal to each other and they are real numbers. So we're dealing with equal real roots, which means that we need to use this formula to find the general solution because this is the formula you use when you have equal real roots. And we would go ahead and plug in our equal real roots for r sub 1, and r sub 1 here in our formula, and we'd find this general solution for y of x. And in this case, you can see we've been given the general solution for y of x. And so when you're asked to work backwards, you just need to identify, first of all, which formula most closely resembles the form in which your original problem is given to you. And in this case, obviously, it's this formula here for y of x. You can tell by looking at it that we've got these roots here, negative 10 and negative 10, so you know that they're equal real roots, and you know then that you can use the equal real roots formula. So once you've kind of identified the formula and you know you've gotten equal real roots, you know that you're factoring, you know already you can get to this step here, right? That your factoring is going to be r plus 10 times r plus 10 equals 0. So that would be your first step in this problem, because given these equal real roots, right, the solutions are negative 10 and negative 10. So you can go ahead and write out this factored version of the original equation. And then you would just multiply things out here. So you'd get r squared plus 10r plus 10r gives you 20r plus 100 equals 0. And then from that point, you would just go ahead and replace the r squared r and this implied 1 right here with this y double prime, y prime, and 100 y equals 0. And that's the way that you would work backwards. So it's really all about just identifying whether you're dealing with equal real roots, distinct real roots, complex conjugate roots, you know, whatever your particular problem calls for, figuring out this formula here so that you can take your roots and plug them back in to however you would have needed to factor in order to get to this point where you have this equation for y of x. So anyway, that's kind of the thinking in terms of working backwards from the general solution to the original problem. I hope that video helped you guys a little bit, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!